Hello people, this is a short video. I wanted to start up the car and show you there's a squeaky noise, but I think I just found it. Before I start up the car, I was checking under the hood here. And if you turn the AC clutch, it's kind of hard for me to get in there. I don't know if you can hear that or not. I think that's what that noise is. I'll go ahead and start it up, and that way you can hear it. The thing I don't like is that pass key is on there, and I'll show you also the ABS is on there too. But first, let me get, if you can hear it. I'm pretty sure that's what that noise is. The AC is not turning. Now, this car is pretty clean. As you can see, the inner fenders are good. Also, the battery doesn't look that old. Here's the other inner fender. I took some stills of this, but here's the dent on the passenger side front fender. I'm trying to get on a good angle so it shows up. The guy seems to think, the dealer, that we could just, somebody can pull it out, but I think it's beyond that. I think the fender needs to be pulled. There's a little bit of rust right there and stuff, but everything else is pretty good. The engine's pretty clean. And the only other thing, there is a bad spot in the grill here. Right here. Maybe my new buddy, sorry I forgot your username, but the guy that was going to pick up a badge for me, maybe he can give me another grill. I want to show the inside here that there's no rust. It's perfect. It's like brand new car all the way down. The rockers are good. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this or not, but oh yeah, I can. Even underneath the doors. I like new. That's the driver's door. Of course, this thing doesn't want to. Oh, I bet you I did that. Hold on. Hold on. I screwed up the zoom, sorry. But as usual, you know, these are always coming loose. Oh shit. Yeah, they did come loose. Huh. I shouldn't have pulled on it. Anyway, another shot of the inside of the doors. All the way around. In perfect shape. Even here. That comes through or not. Absolutely no rust on this car whatsoever. Interior is really nice and clean. And no rust here even. Here's a tiny bit here. Here's a little tiny bit over there. But underneath the tail light. But over here is good. I need to take a still of that. So I can get all the picture or get all the codes off of it. Anyway, it's a nice solid car. Everything's good on it. Even the wiper up there and the washer both work. I've already tried that. Here's the badge that come off. Really quickly. Here's what it's supposed to look like. And this, I don't know what happened here with the gas cap. There's a little divot right here. It's almost like somebody, I don't know what they did. They tried opening up too much and I don't know, but it actually hits right here. When I was driving it yesterday, there was a rattle coming from the back. And this vent window was open and it was rattling because these tires are junk. Then once you get over 60, it starts being pretty wobbly. Other than that, the rims are in decent shape. They're not all rusted. There's a little tiny bit of rust on that one, but I guess since I'm doing this, I'll open up the doors. Open up the back door and stuff. Let me show you how clean everything is. And for you guys on the Buick forum, there's all the sheets I printed up with all the information that you guys sent me or told me about going out of sticky threads and everything. And here's another shot of that door. Absolutely no rust at all the way up, all the way down. On this side, absolutely nothing, all the way up. Anyway, the interior is in great shape. Carpet's a little dirty, but seats are comfortable. They're not ripped or nothing. Could use a shampooing, but now there's one thing I want to do real fast, and that's show you this deal with the ABS. Well, it's actually a little cold out here today. Hold on a sec, I gotta take my glove off here. Alright, let's do this ABS thing. Okay, temperature and off. Goes into diagnostic mode and I hit the fan and then it's at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's ABS part, I know that. Hit the middle switch. Look what it does. Just two dashes. What the hell does that mean? I've asked this already on the thread, but I have no idea what that means. Even when I hit the brakes, nothing happens. I don't, no codes come up. So, I don't know if somebody can help me with this or what. It just does that all the time. If I go to, I forgot what it was. What was it, 24? I believe that's the water temperature. I don't know, I forgot now. I was playing around with it yesterday while I was driving. Oh, here it is. Yeah, 24 is coolant temp. Number 6 is oops, wrong way. That must be the 700. Let's see what happens here. Yeah. Yeah, there's 1100, 1200. 1500. I was driving around 70, right around 70 yesterday. It was right at 1500, I believe. This does have the small or smaller numerically rear end, the 256. And for again, for the guys on the Buick forum, Mr. Buick Magnum guy, he was right about the this numerically smaller rear end shifting in and out of overdrive. Anytime you hit a grade, it'll plop back down into third gear, then upshift again into fourth. And once you got on top of the grade, but anyway, like I said, that I don't know. Again, let's go back to oops. Again, here's the problem I got. Go back to four, and all it does is two dashes. And my analog brake light is still on. I don't know if you can see it or not. There it is. So, anyway, I thought I'd zoom in here. I don't know if I can get it in here. And show you the odometer. 86,000? I thought it was 84,000. Sorry, my bad. 86,773. We put 200 and some miles on it yesterday coming driving home. But it's a nice car. Like I said, it's pretty clean for the age and everything. It's got the Twilight Sentinel for the lights. I'll find out. There's a guy on eBay that actually, he said he has a 94 stereo that he puts in the jack for the iPod. I've actually got that in my 87 Cutlass. So that way, I know there's a sticky on there about how the guy made the, soldered in the thing in the back and then used this shelf here to put his iPod. But, I'll still do that, but I could get the whole stereo from the guy for like $200, and I'll have the jack right on the front. I just plug it in. But other than that, this is a, you know, I think it's a nice car for the money. I love the color. I love blue. So I love the blue interior. So I'm happy with it. I just got to get this fixed, and I just talked to the locksmith guy, because when you the one guy that's going to give me the badging, he's talking about how that the thing might not start one time. Well, I talked to the locksmith, and he said that it could, you know, could happen, but he said the pass key will probably start flashing, not stay on solid. He goes, this is the first car I've ever seen with it staying on solid. So I got the resistor. He told me which blank it was, so I got the right, I'll get the right resistor at Radio Shack, and then I'll see how much of a pain in the ass it's going to be to hook this up down there. If not, he said he can just put a whole new ignition switch on, but it's going to cost like, you know, $250. With his labor and the switch and all that crap, so, and a couple of keys. So, we'll see what happens here, but anyway, just thought I'd take a video and show everything. I originally took the video, like I said, because of the noise under the hood, but I think I just answered my own question when I spun that air conditioning compressor when the engine wasn't running. So, alright, people, later.